Action Works Entertainment is proud to present Sitting on a Tailgate Podcast with your host, DJ Big Country.
I'm just sitting here pressing buttons. It's Wednesday night here at Sitting on a Tailgate. I'm your host, Big Country, and I feel like crap. Let me tell you, it started Sunday night. It hit me like a ton of bricks. I couldn't figure out what it was. I think I got a chest and a sinus infection, but about 11:30, man, my whole body went into convulsing mode, and I started chilling like a villain, and I felt like I was in a freezer, and my head was on fire, and everything else. So I've been sucking on every kind of antibiotic and drug you can think of, and I'm still not quite over it. So I want to know, whoever kissed me and gave me this damn shit, excuse my French, I got a bounty out on you. I don't know who it was. I really ain't done much. I ain't gone nowhere. So hell, I don't know. So, what's going on, people? I mean, if I sound a little bit funny, just, you know, hey. Sorry about that. I don't know what to tell you. But, it's Wednesday right here. It's sitting on a tailgate. We're chilling. And we got a great bunch of guys tonight that we're interviewing. We got the Electric Cowboys. They won a bunch of awards here, what was it, 2 weeks ago at the first annual Josie's Award there in Nashville. I think they won Modern Song of the Year. I think they won Video of the Year, too, if I'm not mistaken. But we'll be talking to Jason, the lead singer for the group, here shortly. But I told him I'd give him a shout here in a few, but other than that, what else is going on, folks? I need to get over this crap because I got a busy week next week. Biketoberfest is here in town, and I'll be gone for 4 days out to Daytona working at the Cabbage Patch, so make sure you guys come and check me out. Also, the Coleslaw, the world-famous Coleslaw Wrestling on Saturday, don't forget. But I'll be playing the music and spinning it for you till wee hours of the morning every night out there. So come and hang out. Maybe we'll try to do a live show. I don't know. I have to check the internet connection out there and see what it's like, because I don't know. I mean, this place is out in the middle of no man's land. Well, actually, it's like at the intersection of a crossroad. There's a blinking yellow light and a stop sign. And then the bar is right there on the corner. Everything else is nothing but woods. So, I guess it is kind of out in the middle of nowhere. So, yeah, I'm sniffing and snotting, snorting too. My cat told me the other morning when I woke up feeling like crap, he'd come in and he said, hey. He said, either go to the doctor or quit your damn getting your disease on me. I looked at him and I said, damn, you can talk. That was a good one. Oh my god, I feel like crap. But anyways, Friday we got the Lunchtime Country Jam at noon. We got a brand new single coming out from an artist that will be debuting her new single Friday. I think you'll like it. It's by Maggie Baugh. And, I think you'll really, really like it. So you might want to check out our show Friday at the Lunchtime Country Jam at noontime. Right here on our website, www.wbcwradio.com. And then don't forget our brand new show that we started on Saturday mornings, the Saturday Morning Sinkholes at 10 a.m., every Saturday morning with me and Sarah Lee. And we are winging it as we go. We're trying to find different things to talk about. We're playing it by ear until we get going and getting in some kind of rhythm. So, but it'll be good. You'll like it. We've already had 72 plays on our show from our first show, so that's not bad. That's pretty good. So I think you'll like it. I think it'll turn out to be a good deal. But let's see what we got here real quick before we call him. But I'm trying to think if I forgot anything while I'm doing this. Probably. I'm sure I'll remember it again, though. But, yeah, so check this song out. This is by the Electric Cowboys. This is what they won Video of the Year and Original Song of the Year. This is called Little While.
You're the one who changed my style. You're
So that's the song that they won Original Song of the Year and Video of the Year. You can check out the video. Go on, I believe it's on YouTube, iTunes. You can also go on their Facebook page. It's on there. Check out their website. Actually, go to their Reverb Nation page, reverbnation.com/the Electric Cowboys. You can see the video on there, but great bunch of guys. We're going to talk to him here in just a second. So far, so good with me. I went to Taco Bell and got some dinner, and nothing has happened yet. So, yeah, I said something now, so watch. I'll be in trouble. It sucks because when you're sick, you don't feel like eating. And then when you get to the point where you do eat, anything you do eat goes right through you. And let me tell you, I won't go into details, but I'm sure most of y'all know. Yeah, buddy. But, that's kind of how I feel. But what else we got going on? Got a lot of political news. I don't know. I don't feel like talking political news. Let's just we'll call these guys and instead of wasting y'all's time here. Let's get here some dialing music. Do. My nose is draining. Everything's draining. Calgon, take me away. Morning. Where are you calling from?
Dude, I'm on musician time. Every time of the day.
Oh yeah. That's right. What time? Let's see. It's 8:15. Yeah, 8:15. You guys are probably just now waking up.
Dude, 8:15. I'm waking up now to do a show, man, and go to bed at 6:00 in the morning. How's it going over there, man?
What's going on, man? Hey, it's Electric Cowboys, everybody. This is I'm talking to Jason, right?
Yeah, this is Jason, brother.
Jason Martinez is lead vocals, and Tim, don't tell me, I'm going to get these right, Tim Valentina? No.
Close.
Villanova.
There you go.
Tim Villanova, Tim Villanova, he's on the drums, and Mike Molini?
Yes, sir.
He's on the keyboards. Now I know where I've heard you guys from. I've heard your sound. I'm going to tell you this. I don't know how many people has told you, and I just realized where the number I was calling to. You guys sound like old Diamond Rio, old Little Texas. Do you get that a lot?
You know what? We actually kind of do. You know, those cats are big influences, and the cool thing about bands like that is that, you know, like their writing style and their arrangement style is so, you know, like their songs are easy to dance to, and their songs, as far as, you know, being written, they write real songs about real people, and we kind of like try to do the same. Well, we don't so much try to go for that, but for some reason, it kind of comes out like that a little bit, and we're very proud to say, you know, whenever someone says that to us, we're very proud to, you know, it feels good.
I was going
to
say, yeah, it should, because, I mean, you know, back in the day, man, them guys were the shit. I mean, they were on the top charts all the damn time, and that's all I ever listened to.
Yeah, man, those guys are bad. We really love those guys.
So where are you guys playing at tonight in Texas?
Tonight, we're actually off tonight. We're off tonight, and then we leave tomorrow night, and we're headed over to Victoria, Texas on Friday, and then from there we're doing Angleton, Texas, and from Angleton we're doing Houston on Sunday. So we got 3 days out this week, and then I think we're home for 2 days, and then we're gone again, like on Tuesday or Wednesday. But lucky for us, it's kind of like an East Texas tour this weekend. It's not going to be too hard. But we look forward to rocking out where we go, man. Definitely.
Now, are you guys based out of Nashville, or are you based out of Texas?
We're based out of Texas. Okay. And it's crazy because, you know, down here in Texas, you have, you know, like Texas music. You got Kevin Fowler, and,
right,
and you got Randy Rogers and those cats, you know, and it's, So everybody expected us to kind of be very Texas-like, you know?
Right.
But our brand of country, you know, like you've heard it, you know, it's kind of a mix between, you know, those cats you were talking about, and at the same time, you know, we like the natural stuff of then and the natural stuff of now. So you're going to find, like, a big old mix of styles within our style of music because we like so much of it, you know what I mean? The range is just so huge, and we try to take advantage of what we like to do because you always play best whatever you like doing the best.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Well, you definitely need to send me some more music because I only got the one song that you guys sent to me. So whoever's in charge of your promotion, tell them to get on the stick. That way I can tell, because from just hearing from the one song, I like what I hear because of the old style, but from the way you look, I mean, I'm thinking of Pearl Jam, or I'm thinking of Muse, you know, some rock and roll, because I do Toberfest and Bike Week every year here in Daytona. And so I'm around all that stuff that time. I play the music, you know, so, and I grew up with it too. So, but that's I kind of like the mixture there, and it's good because you guys are kind of in the middle, and you're in the middle of the country and the classic rock, not the country and the hip hop. I like that. I would rather have that.
That's the cool thing is, like, two of our favorite types of music, of course, are country music and classic rock, you know,
right.
And when we go up there, we, you know, because you see a lot of these cats right now going up there and they're wearing, you know, nice shirts and they're wearing the chains and the caps, yeah, but we're a little more grungy, you know, like, I'll go up there with a Guns N' Roses t-shirt,
right.
and we'll rock out some of these tunes and do these three-part harmonies, and then we'll bust into, like, a Journey song, and people are like, whoa, you know, what the hell happened here, you know?
Yeah, right.
Man, because we like that stuff, too, you know, or, like, we'll bust into a Boston tune or Sticks, and all of a sudden, people are turning their heads going, whoa, what just happened here, you know? And it's one of those things where we enjoy playing that music, so we actually throw that kind of stuff into the show, just to kind of show the versatility of the guys, you know, because we all grew up on all those different genres of music,
right.
And we all love to play those different genres. It's cool.
Right. What's your opinion on the new bro country that's coming out? I've asked a bunch of artists already, but I'm just kind of, I want to get your feeling because you guys are more hardcore in the country and southern rock.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
There's a couple of ways that I actually look at it, because I look at it from a country and a country rocker point of view. And then I also look at it from, like, a classic country lover, and I also look at it from a business point of view. So this is what I think. I am not a huge fan of the actual bro country music that's coming out.
Right.
But I am a huge fan of the artists that are able to make a huge living in a business sense from doing that music.
Right,
you know?
Yeah.
Some of the music I listen to, and I'm like, you know what? This is catchy. And I know for a fact that this is going to be hitting with the kids.
Yeah,
that's smart.
That's
smart. You know,
it is with the kids and me. Since as long as I've been playing venues for the last 20 plus years, I can see that over the last, I'd say at least 10 years, there's been a lot of venues go by the wayside and go under that don't strictly deal with country music. You don't see those anymore unless you go out in the middle of East Chuckafuck, excuse my French, and yeah, I'm serious. You don't see them like in downtown Orlando here. You wouldn't see them in downtown Houston because it's a different culture with the kids. And
right.
Country music is not what the kids want to hear. They want to hear a dance beat with it, like maybe Colt Ford or Twangin' Round. You know, just depends. But
exactly.
they don't want the old school country. And it's a shame because I think in the next 10, 15 years, we're going to lose old school country unless we really keep people like me around to play it.
Yeah, and see, and that's where guys like you, we appreciate cats like you that are spinning this music and spinning our music because, you know, it kind of helps keep that sense, that aspect of the music alive because check this out. Like, I can't say, well, I really can't say that I don't like it because there's some stuff that I do like. And like
oh, yeah,
said,
there's
you know,
stuff, yeah, there's stuff I like. I mean, there's stuff I like.
And then there's stuff that I totally respect. And then and now occasionally I will hear a song and go, really? Somebody approve that? Come on.
You know I mean?
But then again, you know, and I'm looking at it this way, man. Look, back in the day, and I know, and I'm not really, you know, that old, but I have an old soul. So I like my wife and I were listening to Willie Nelson yesterday, as a matter of fact. And I was, you know, and she's like me, you know, she analyzes everything on the radio. And she's going, you know, we're going, you know what? They don't write anything like this anymore. They used to write real songs about real people.
Right. Yeah. They
songs that I could really. Yeah, man. I miss the, I you know, back, they used to write about the I love yous and I hate yous, the I need yous and the F yous, right? You know?
Yep. I blame Nashville corporate for that just because of what they're doing. I blame them because they want to get songwriters in, they want to get these artists into the songwriters and producers and run a song and get it tracked and mixed, and they want it out the door and on the charts within a few weeks. They don't want to take their time and actually writing a song.
Exactly, and that's where the key is, because I will tell you something, man, and just in music in general, I will not remember, in 10 years, I'm not going to remember any Rihanna song, but you can sure as hell bet that I will remember Journey faithfully 10 years from now. You know what I mean?
Right.
And you're talking about 30, 40 years later that it was recorded. You know, I will always remember Folsom Prison Blues. I will always remember, shoot, man, I will always remember groups like Diamond Rio, Shenandoah, Little Texas, you know, and you know, cats like that, man, and Clint Black and Garth Brooks. These guys were just monsters in country back in the day. And I don't know if I'm going to remember some of these cats later on, you know, and that's the point of music is you want, as far as business is, you want to be memorable. You want, right. Like the music used to have really cool intros and really cool riffs,
yep.
And stuff that you would remember and try to learn, and melodies, man. Solos had melodies. Dude, they had melodies.
Oh, yeah.
And
yep.
Oh, my gosh. And like I said, there's some stuff that I dig today. It's cool, you know. But there are some things that I'm like, oh, man, you know, I just wish you would try it a little bit harder to connect with guys like me, you know what I mean? Because I didn't grow up on a farm, so I don't know what it's like to bale hay, but I sure as heck know what it's like to get my heart broken by my 6th or 7th grade girlfriend, you know what I mean?
Oh, so you're a concrete cowboy.
I'm a concrete cowboy rocker, man. I know what it's like, man. I grew up on the outskirts of San Antonio,
right.
I didn't live on the farm, but man, I lived through all the heartache and all that stuff.
Right.
And that's the stuff that we sing about. And Little Wild's like that. The song that we have right now, the one that's out right now, it's a song about a guy, well, really, I mean, it can be either way, right? But, you know, personally for me, it's a song about a guy that messed up royally and then finds this woman that just turns his life around. And, yeah, it's cliche. It's cliche, but the way that we wrote that song isn't like the way somebody else would write it. Like, nowadays, it'd be like, hey, girl, bring them shorts over here.
Right,
and
yeah.
You know what, and then I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. No, man, this is me telling you, you know what, I was a screw-up, I was terrible, and now you've changed my life around, and I love you, girl, you know what I mean?
I tell you what, if they can get an artist here, a local new artist right now, you know, today's artist, to actually sit down with a writer or a producer and actually write a song with a beat to it and old school lyrics talking about love and stuff like that, then you might have something. You might see, if somebody does that, I guarantee you country will do two things. They'll flip their lids or they'll run with it and say this might work, and then they'll just change it all. They'll change it all over again like they've been doing.
Man, and okay, there you go. Now, you just brought something up, man, that's key. It's keynote and everything in all genres of music, and it's that every genre evolves from one type to another. So country music now, it sounds nothing like it did in the 90s, which sounds nothing like it did in the 80s and 70s and 60s.
Right, yeah.
So I'm hoping that it'll evolve into something else. Like, I started seeing a little bit of that singer-songwriter thing come back where, you know, songwriters are just, you know, writing a little more meaningful, but it's not out in mainstream yet. Like, right. Okay, so like, for example, I was in Nashville last week, right? We went to Nashville for the Country Blast Music Award.
Right, yeah, I know.
And that song, yeah, we won Modern Country Song of the Year, which is cool, right? I was like, yeah, that's great.
Didn't you guys win Video of the Year, too?
No, we didn't get Video of the Year.
Oh, okay.
But we didn't get Video of the Year, but we got Country Song of the Year, and that was really cool, you know, because it's like, finally, you know, somebody is listening to the stuff that we're putting out.
Right, yeah.
Now, check this out. The next day, I went and I got the opportunity to sing at the Bluebird Cafe in Nashville.
Mm-hmm, yep.
And that was, that was bucket list. That was really, really
right,
cool.
Right, yeah.
And everybody that went up there and sang a song had meaning behind their song.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and it didn't matter whether they sang great or they didn't, but everybody tried really hard to get some sort of a point across that was relatable to some people. You know, there was a cat up there that went up there and started singing about how you know, how it's hard being married to somebody for so long. And I'm thinking to myself, there's a lot of people that probably feel that way.
Yeah.
You know, and then there's somebody else said, there was another girl that went up there and she blew my mind singing about how I wish that you would treat me as good as you do that car you have in the garage, you know? And I'm thinking, that's cool, man.
Right. Yeah, I know.
You know, that's cool. You know, and you don't find that stuff in mainstream radio. We got turned down by a couple of labels. And I remember one of them told me, well, you don't sound anything like Luke Bryan. And I was like, well, that's kind of the point, you know?
Yeah,
and
exactly.
And don't get me wrong, the guy's awesome, man. He's bad, you know, and the show is great.
Right.
I love the cat. I'm not going to lie. He's one of those guys that's doing very well. And,
right.
And I dig it, man. You know, I'm a fan. I definitely am. But we don't have to sound like that to try to get somewhere with our music, you know?
Right, yeah.
We just don't write like that, and we don't arrange like that, you know? And the stuff, like, there's some cuts off the record that are actually a little more rocking as well, you know?
Yeah.
They're a little more gritty, but they're a lot of fun.
Well, that's fine, because, if you know, I look at it this way. Nashville's going to have to figure in the next couple of years that they're not going to be able to change country music. There's no way you can have country music and take the guitar and the banjo and the steel guitar and drums out of the equation and put in a beatbox and a synthesizer.
Right.
Yeah, you just can't do it. Not with country music, because it's too original.
Exactly. Exactly. If that happens, well, then you might as well move that artist or that song to another station that plays something else.
All right.
Because I am all for musical equality, definitely. But at the same time, you know, I'll go to the classic country station or to these, you know, these stations or to your station, and I'm listening because you guys are giving us stuff stuff like guys that like me can appreciate, you know.
Right.
You'll make me laugh. You'll make me feel good. You'll make me cry, and you'll make me mad. If you can, man, make me feel those emotions,
right,
dude, I'm gonna listen to you forever.
Right.
You know?
I know. Right.
Now, yeah. I mean.
Oh yeah, I know. I know. That's the way it was growing up. I mean, you know,
yeah, exactly.
Reba McEntire, Johnny Cash, Loretta Lynn. I mean, the list goes on and on.
Oh yeah.
But,
it was bad back then, you know, and I was showing my 8-year-old nephew yesterday because we were barbecuing or something outside and we were kind of hanging out, and I said, you know what, I'm gonna, because he likes country music, and I said, I'm gonna show him some stuff. So I started showing him, you know, like some Johnny Cash, you know, like the typical outlaw country, you know, Johnny, Waylon, and Hank, and
right.
and all those cats, and he was like, he tells me, he says Uncle Jay, he says, I like that. I said, it's cool, right? He goes, yeah, you know, it's like it kind of gave him a feeling of like he's not supposed to be listening to Folsom Prison Blues.
Right, yeah.
You know?
That's the thing. Yeah, see, nobody teaches the kids today what we used to listen to, because everybody says, oh, change is good. Well, certain changes are good, but not everything is good for a change. You know, old stuff you still should listen to. And that's the problem. Do you realize here in Orlando there is only 2 country FM stations?
Wow, really?
2. And one of them just started not even 2 years ago. It only had been one for the last 8. Well, the one has been here in Orlando for, well, let's see, I'm 45, and they've been here ever since I can remember, so at least 30 years. But the other one just started, probably about 2 years. And the guy that started it, he actually worked for the other station for a while. But,
oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, yeah, and they concentrate on old country. They play new and old. The station that's been around for a long time, they don't do that. You can take the channel and flip it on and hear something within an hour. You can hear the same thing. It's just a...
Wow.
Yeah, just a constant rotation. And I feel that internet radio is going to be the future. I feel in the next 5 to 6 years, internet radio is going to take over FM waves, because everybody and their brother is trying to start some kind of radio station. They've already shut down tons of radio stations overseas. Finland has already closed all 5 of their main FM stations over there, because they make over $52 million in downloaded music alone over there.
Wow.
Yeah, and this is the this is Finland. So, yeah, they don't need FM stations. They're saving money. So, yeah, internet radio is going to be the bomb.
Oh, I agree totally. And internet radio is what's giving us what we want. You know,
right?
I'll flip on the FM station over here, and it's okay. And you're right. I hear one song. Okay, great. And then an hour later, I'll hear the same song or the same artist, and I'm going, okay, you know. And then an hour later, it's the same thing, and I'm going, oh man, I got to change this because, you know, I want to hear, you know, some variety. I want to hear some cool stuff.
Right.
I want to hear
That's the thing about it too with FM stations. FM stations, they are told what to play, you know, by popularity and whatnot. Internet stations, they're trying like hell. Trust me, they're in court now trying to figure out how the FCC and the BMI and everybody can lock down internet radio and make a profit off of it. Because right now they can't because it's free. It's free network. Anybody can do it. So yeah, trust me, they're trying to market it, and I hope they don't get it. I hope it's still free and clear, and everybody has their way of doing things. And yeah, that'll keep music going forever.
Oh yeah, absolutely, and that's the wave of the future. That's where it's going to go. You know, at least that's where I hope it goes. Because, like I said, it's just the internet radio seems to give us a lot of what. I'm going to say, you know what, I'm going to say that internet radio seems to give me a lot of what I want, you know.
Right.
I'm speaking, of course, on a personal note, and then I know the rest of the guys in the band are the same way, you know. Because nowadays, you don't have to listen to the radio. You can download anything you want onto your iPhone
exactly.
And listen to it whenever you want.
Yep.
So why am I going to bother to turn on a station to listen to random songs that are going to come out over and over when I can make a playlist of 150 songs and listen to myself?
Yep.
You know,
I turn on my radio in my truck anymore when I go somewhere. Leave it off.
That's the point. So all of this is kind of it hurts the industry in a sense that, you know what, artists aren't making the money they used to.
No.
It's harder for an artist to be out there now because of that. But at the same time, radio is making it hard for us to listen to radio because we don't like what's on there anymore. You know what I mean?
That's why you'll see that's why you'll see artists go overseas and push their songs and their music overseas.
And it makes it hard because I feel like all of a sudden the artists and the radio stations are not working together anymore.
No,
you know,
they're not
helping each other. You know, you're leaving guys like us out. You know, and I remember there's been a couple of stations where, you know, where I get a hold of them and they're like, well, no, we can't put you on the station because of the format. I'm thinking, okay, well, it's country music.
Right,
you're not such and such, you know, and I'm like,
right.
Oh, okay, whatever, man, you know, so they go back to playing the same, you know, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 artists and then that's it, you know.
Yeah.
People don't give a lot of thought into that kind of stuff because it is the music business, and yeah, we do it because we love it, but at the same time we have to pay the bills on Monday. So it's our job as well, you know?
Yeah.
So we do it for a number of reasons. So we have to fight to get our music on the air. We have to do what we can to try to get stations to play guys like us because this is how we make a living. Aside from the fact that we love playing music. That's number one, of course, right?
Right? Yeah.
But this is all that we do, and I'm hoping that FM stations start to pick on stuff like that. You know, and there's a lot of stations now that did pick up our music, and I'm very, very happy for that, definitely. But it's, you know, you literally have to fight to get in there, and it's very tough. It's tough, you know. I don't know if it's harder to get on radio now or if it was harder to get on radio then because the pool is so much bigger. Of talented people. Oh my goodness. There's dogs all
over. The dogs are fighting. Who let the dogs out?
Who?
No, I know what you're talking about. I think it's harder now to get your music out than it was back then because back then you actually, the artist, had to actually go to the radio station and hand them either a tape or a CD, or not a CD, but a tape or a record or an 8-track, you know? They had to actually give them their music to play. So now everything is digital.
And if it was like that, it'd be great because I could call you and say, hey, look, bud, I'm going to be in the area this coming Wednesday. Do you mind if I come by and give you my tape? And hell, I'll sing for you right in front of you, brother.
Right.
You know,
come on by. Right. And back then, there wasn't that many artists either. If you noticed how many artists, it's probably quadrupled in the last 20 plus years.
Oh, yeah. Everybody wants to be a rock star.
Right. Yeah.
And you know, games like Rock Band and stuff really brought it to everyone's attention that, you know what, everyone can be a rock star. And I'm glad that everyone has and shoots for their dreams, definitely. But it's tough. It's tough because it just makes it very hard for everybody, you know, like, you know, guys that have been around for a long, long time, you know, trying to get here and trying to get there. And all of a sudden I see a cat, you know, that comes in and automatically gets to the top and they get a deal and this and this. And it's not about jealousy. It's not about anything like that. I'm just going, you know, well, how about you listen to us too? You know what I mean?
Right. Yeah.
And they're like, nah, you're not 17. You're in your late 20s. Yeah, you're not 17. You know what I mean? And I'm going, dude, you know, but, you know, that's why we are grateful for stations like yours, man, that are giving artists like us the opportunity to be heard.
We're trying, man. We're trying to help you guys out as much as I can. Or actually, I should say I'm trying because I'm the only one that runs this contraption over here.
Yeah, and I appreciate that.
I do all the publications and everything. So yeah, we're trying to get the music out for you. But I love doing it. I've been doing music, you know, for 20 plus years. I just started being a full time DJ for the last 8. So, you know, I've done clubs and stuff like that. So, you know, I figured past the time I want to do something, and I figured I might as well run with radio, you know, internet radio, because I'm telling you, it's going to pick up here in the next 5-6 years. And I think I made the right choice. But what you got going on for the holidays, man?
For the holidays, man, we got some crazy tours coming up in the holidays. I don't even know exactly where right now, but I do know that we have a full schedule throughout the rest of the year. We're hoping to head down. I'm hoping to head down to Florida maybe in February, down there, see if we can head over to your neck of the woods and show everybody, you know, show everybody what we've got, and hopefully everybody likes it and keep coming back to the area. You know, we do a lot of Texas, and I didn't even do a lot of like the East Coast and, you know, the up in the Midwest and stuff like that. And,
right.
But, it has been a little bit of a good ride, you know, thanks to the song. It's, you know, coming through, and slowly stations are picking it up. And I do have to say, I do have to tell you that I appreciate what you do for us, man. Thank you very, very much.
Amen, no problem. Tell everybody where they can get your music at.
All right, guys, the easiest place and the best place to get our music and to see everything would be to go to theelectriccowboys.com. If you go to theelectriccowboys.com, it'll shoot you over to our video. So watch the video for a little while, click on it, it'll send you over to YouTube. You can click on a button, it'll go to our Facebook, so like our page. You can click on a button. It'll take you to Twitter. Follow us on Twitter. That is like the main source. And then it'll take you to iTunes and Amazon to buy Little While if you want to hear it or if you want to buy it. So just go to theelectriccowboys.com and you'll find all the info that you need to find, you know, as far as Electric Cowboys goes. It'll take you everywhere. Theelectriccowboys.com.
Okay, sounds good. Hey, listen, appreciate you talking with us. Get up with me. If you got some new music, you can shoot it my way so I can play some more songs for you. But Jason Definitely. From the Electric Cowboys, we appreciate you talking with us tonight and hanging with us. Make sure y'all go get their music. Go to electriccowboys.com, download their music. I really like the song Little While. I think you'll like the video. If you like old school country, Diamond Rio, Little Texas, you'll love it because I love it. Hey, man. Appreciate you talking to us. Have a good night, buddy.
Thank you so much, brother. Y'all take care.
All right, bye-bye. That was good. So, Jason sounds like a cool cat. I think he is. But, we got about 20 minutes. Let's, let me see if I can, we're going to bug somebody here. Hold on. He might be listening. He might not answer the phone. Let's see if he answers the phone. He ain't gonna answer.
Thanks for calling.
Unless he might be working too, but so yeah, Electric Cowboys, make sure you go to their website, download their music. Let's see what we got here in the news. Of course, they did another airstrike today in Russia. And with Russia over there in Syria. And, yeah, they've been, they hit one of the hospitals, which was not cool. So I got a feeling this is going to be a bigger mess than what we thought. I think it's going to be, I think it's going to be a problem, to tell you the truth, because I think, I really think that it's going to piss a lot of people off. But, hey, what can you do? All you can do is sit there and complain and whine, and you can't do nothing about it. Check this out. Violent crime in America dropped 51% as Americans bought 170 million guns. So that right there proves it, folks, that you don't take away guns because of the gun violence. Because how are you going to defend yourself? I understand where they're coming from, but you can't do that because criminals always manage to get a hold of weapons. Plain and simple, period. You can't do that. You can't take away a gun from somebody and have them not to be able to defend themselves, because it just, you just can't do it. But let's see what the statistics on this here says. Let me see here. What does it say? Hold on. We got somebody. Joe's Bar and Grill, can I help you?
Hey, what's happening?
You're on the air, man.
Hey!
I was
what
trying
am
to.
I on?
You're what on,
show?
What show? All of them. All 20 of them.
Nice. Hey, welcome to Big Country's You Fill in the Blank.
Sitting on a tailgate.
Sitting on a tailgate.
What are you doing? Are you on your way home from work?
I just got eaten at Billy Gardell's Pizzeria.
They got good pizza?
I mean, I'll tell you what, no lie, it's the best pizza I've had in Orlando.
Really?
Yeah, it really is.
We got this place over here in Lake Mary area, Sanford area, that's got, it's called Little Italy. And they make I think it's like an 18-inch pizza. I don't know, that's pretty damn huge. Yeah, 18-inch pizza, you can get it for $10.99 anytime during the week, Monday through Thursday. And I swear to God, I think it's the best. It's not like Pizza Hut or Papa John's or Domino's.
Right.
I mean, this is actual, real New York-style pizza.
This is Chicago-style, oven, brick oven baked.
Right.
And it's amazing. It really is amazing. I was talking to Billy's brother, Brian.
Uh-huh.
Billy's supposed to roll into town tomorrow or the next day, and we're going to go over and hang out with him. I got a buddy of mine from New York. His buddy's with Billy Gardell.
Uh-huh.
And so we're all just going to be hanging out. This is what happens when you roll with a big dog.
What are,
so
you,
are we doing a three-way call with somebody, or is it just me?
No, it's just you. I'm just, well, right. I'll fart around with that later. I don't think I can do it because the way my phone's set up, but I'll figure it out. But we're going to try to get you on the Saturday morning show one time.
All right,
yeah,
very cool.
So we'll figure it out because I don't.
I got shows in Daytona this weekend.
This weekend?
So if anybody is.
Yeah, go ahead, plug
it. If anybody's in the Daytona area, I'm at the Joke Factory Comedy Club. It's inside. It's on the 10th floor of the La Playa Resort. It's closer to Ormond. Or Ormond, if you're a foreigner.
Ormond.
And, so, yeah, it's right across from the Publix, the La Playa Resort, 10th floor, Joke Factory Comedy Club. I'll be there with my buddy Jeffrey Allen, who's opening up for me. And I'll be there Friday night and Saturday night. Both shows are at 9 o'clock.
What do you got going on the following weekend? Because I'll be at Biketoberfest. You need to come and hang out with me.
I don't know. Maybe going to Hollow Scream. I think some friends of ours are going to Hollow Scream on next Saturday. But yeah, Biketoberfest. I need to go to Biketoberfest. I've never been. As long as I've lived down here, I've never been to Biketoberfest or Bike Week.
Well, don't feel bad, because as long as I've lived here, I've never been to Halloween Horror Nights.
Well, yeah, I'm not going to Halloween Horror Nights.
Well, isn't that the same thing as Hollow Scream?
Hollow Scream is in Tampa. It's at Busch Gardens.
Oh, okay. I got you.
And I get it for free there. So I ain't paying for
How do you get? Who do you know down there?
Well, it's all the same company, man.
Oh, yeah. Okay, never mind. I had a brain fart there for about a second.
So am I your only guest tonight, or do you have somebody else?
No. I had the lead singer from the Electric Cowboys. I've played their song before. I swear them guys are going to go huge because they have the sound of Diamond Rio and Little Texas, and they're based out of Texas. And he grew up on the Southern Rock and the old country. So, yeah, I think they're going to do real good.
Oh, very cool.
What are we talking about Saturday morning?
NASCAR.
Yeah, no kidding, really?
No.
For any of y'all who don't know, me and Vic, well, Vic does, but I come in at the tail end. Just depends on who doesn't call in or who calls in. But Vic does a Saturday morning show on the Victory Lane radio broadcast called On the Road. And he talks about NASCAR and talks about tailgating barbecue. And then I bring up the tail end with your tailgating music.
That's exactly right. We have you bring in, and what I like about it is, and same thing with your show, it's basically your show in about 10 minutes.
Right.
Where you bring in, you have a little bit of throwback, but you bring in a lot of newer artists that people don't know about or don't know about yet, and you play them on your show, but on your segment on my show, you give the... you just give us a highlight of people to check out throughout the week.
You're right.
And so it's a good little segment. Everybody seems to enjoy it. I've been getting a lot of good compliments on it.
Okay, we're going to do a quiz real quick. It's called Stump Vic. Right. It's called Stump Vic.
Let's do it.
Let me see if I can...
It won't be too hard.
I probably won't even be able to get it back up on the thing here. Let me see here. Hold on. Where's that? Oh, here we go. Okay. 51% of violent crimes has dropped because of 170 million guns purchased in the last year. What's your take on that?
What's my take on it?
No, not in the last year, since 1991. Because they've been talking about how gun violence needs to be stopped by taking away guns, but now they're bringing out, this is from FBI and ATF stats. Since 1991, since 1991, 51% violence has dropped because of people buying 170 million guns.
It's just logic. The criminals don't know who they can mug anymore.
Right.
Especially for those that talk and carry, and they don't know who they can go in. They don't know if they walk into a house if they're going to die.
Right.
They don't know if they try to carjack you, if you're going to pull a gun.
And I think that's why
a video was on Facebook.
Right.
And this guy pulled into his garage, was shutting his door. And these two hoods slip under the garage door to steal his car or to attack him or whatever. He jumps out of his car with his gun and starts shooting them.
Yeah.
And people don't know whether they're running into this. So it's logic. It's just a matter of numbers. You have more and more people buying guns and more people packing and with their concealed weapons license. And some states now are passing laws where you have an open carry policy, where you can walk into a place and you have your gun on your hip, and people see that you do have your gun on your hip. And some places don't even have a concealed weapons license. You can just carry your gun.
Right.
So I would imagine places like Texas and maybe Kentucky or maybe some of the other places like that would have probably the least amount of violent crimes due to that very reason. And it's surprising that one of the most stringent gun laws in America is Chicago, and they've had over 6,000 gun shootings in the past since 2009.
Well, I think these thugs, see, they're starting to figure out that they're going to come to, if I think the ones that actually sit and plan out the job are going to come packing because they are predicting that they're going to run into some kind of resistance. But if you got somebody that's just, you know, zonked out on cocaine or drugs or whatever, just trying to steal change or booze or whatever, they're not going to think about it. So that's what they're, that's they're starting to get afraid because they know people are starting to arm themselves.
Oh yeah, and it's amazing what people are arming themselves. There's so many of them. We talk about being a victim country, but there's so many of us that are tired of being victims or putting ourselves in a position to become a victim.
Right.
Where we decide we're not going to take it anymore.
Right.
Even grandmas, you got pistol packing grandmas now.
Oh yeah, I know, right? Your grandma pack your grandma pack a pistol?
My grandma would shoot the wings off a fly at 100 paces. I can tell you that.
Well, that's because they're from.
I grew up in Kentucky. Everybody knows.
I was going to say that's because they're from Kentucky.
That's right, because we can shoot our guns.
Yeah.
Either Kentucky or you get shot.
This judge here, this was posted by Rush Limbaugh. This judge, this lady judge, says, when the gunman realizes that nobody else is armed, he will lay down his weapons and turn himself in. That's just human nature. Wrong.
Oh, yeah.
Wrong.
Yeah, that's crazy.
It's amazing.
Crazy.
Yeah, and she's a judge. It's amazing how some of these IGMOs come up with some of these statements and think that they know everything.
Oh yeah, well they're making it. The gun laws do nothing but disarm the citizens. And I just heard a guy. It was kind of a little spoof of being president. He called himself the virtual president. I don't know if you saw it on my Facebook page, Rick Clever.
Oh yeah. I saw that video.
The guy was like, "There's two types of people. There's non-predators and predators.
Yep.
And the predators go after the non-predators." And what you're telling us is that gazelle, whose only line of defense is its horns, you want that gazelle to dehorn because for some reason that's going to help protect it against the cheetah.
Right, yeah.
And that's just crazy. I'm like, oh man, that is the coolest analogy that I've ever heard.
It is. And the guy was spot on, too, when he talked. I mean, if you didn't pay attention to what he was saying, you would kind of get lost if you didn't understand what he was saying. But
right.
Yeah, he was spot on.
And more murders have been committed over the past couple of years with a hammer than have with rifles.
Yep, definitely.
Like twice as much in the past year or something like that. And nobody's said anything about that. So,
what
are they going to do?
So you ain't been doing nothing tonight, huh?
I ain't done nothing. I went to eat pizza.
Bring me some ice cream. Bring me some ice cream.
Huh?
Bring me some ice cream.
I didn't get ice cream. I had pizza.
Where's mom? Did she come with you?
Yeah, she's... We had to go... That's where a buddy of mine met us, and she's driving his convertible.
Oh, is this convertible broke down? Or he's drunk?
he has no reason. He's from New York.
Oh, okay. So she's driving.
So she's driving. And because she's like, oh, I've never driven a convertible before. I'm going to drive your convertible.
That way he don't...
He flew in and got a rental.
That way he don't end up in Hollipaw.
Exactly. And he had a few beers while we were sitting there, so...
Right.
That's another reason for him to be driven home. So.
Well, I figured I'd call you and debug you.
Well, I appreciate it. That's why I live for it.
I know you do. You ain't got nothing else to do, so...
I have nothing else to do.
I know. All right, people. Vic Clevenger, don't forget to check him out Saturday at the Daytona what now?
It's called the Joke Factory. It's at the La Playa. It's in Daytona Beach. Almost to Ormond.
It's right there on A1A, right?
Right there on A1A.
Yep.
If you're going north on A1A out of Daytona Beach, it'll be on your right-hand side.
Can't miss it, man.
It's floor. It's a big penthouse nightclub, and I need to get their tickets because it will sell out. It does every time I'm there.
Sounds good, man. All right, Bubba. I'll holler at you later.
All right, brother.
See you, man.
All right, man. Talk to you Saturday.
All right, bye.
All right, bye.
Bye. Yay. So that's Mr. Vic Clevenger. I figured we'd bug him, but I found this video. He was talking about this virtual president. If anybody of y'all haven't seen this yet or heard about it, let's see here. Take a listen to it real quick.
And now, we must turn to the issue of gun violence in America today, because the latest mass shootings in Aurora, Colorado, and Newtown, Connecticut leave us all liberal and conservative, Republican and Democrat, appalled and disgusted at the carnage. Now, some people, and that includes many of you in this room tonight, want to place the blame for this horror on things like 30-round magazines or semi-automatic rifles. We want to blame something, anything, that we can control. But what we really want to ban is violence and murder and insanity. Now, we don't talk about that, though, because deep in our hearts, each of us knows that violence and murder and insanity are built into the human condition and likely always will be. You know, there are two kinds of animals in this world, predators and prey. No one watches a leopard chase down a gazelle and denies that the gazelle has a right to use its hooves and horns to protect itself from the predator. But there are people in this room tonight and all across the country who would deny that same right to self-defense to other human beings. Such people seem to think that the way to stop the leopard is to cut the horns off of the gazelle, that by somehow making it easier for the predator will simply go away. My friends, this is insane. When you make it easier for the predator, you get more predators.
He does have an idea. He's got the right idea. You can check out the video. You can go to Sitting on a Tailgate on Facebook. It's posted on there. Or if you just want to check it out, it's floating around the internet. Just go to Sitting on a Tailgate on Facebook, facebook.com/backwoods music, BAKWOODS music, and check out the video. But it's cool. It's called The Virtual President, and it's he's got a lot of interesting things to say about that. It's not a very long video, but this crap about gun violence, people, it ain't going away anytime soon, and we're probably not going to get a handle on it because nobody wants to sit. It's just like anything. Nobody wants to sit and actually talk about things and try to work it out and see what they can't do to solve the problem. That's the whole issue. So, but anyways, what else we got going on? Don't forget, Friday noontime is the Lunchtime Country Jam. It's be at noontime on the Florida Country Radio Network. Saturday morning is the Saturday morning sinkhole show with BC and Sarah Lee. It starts at 10 o'clock right here on WBCWRadio.com. You can check that out. Next week, we got another interview before I take off and head to Bike Week in Daytona, or Biketoberfest, I should say. Next week, we are interviewing a great friend of mine. Her name is Melissa Ramsky. This is her song from this is her latest single, but I think you'll like it. Check it out.
Long till I get bored. There's a million of you and one of me, so who needs two more? You'll do anything in this world to buy me over. At the end of the day, I'll throw you away and count my losses, which is none. I'm just having fun. They said that you can call me a gold digger. In this case, I disagree. It's not my fault these men get whatever my blue eyes see. And at the end of the day, I walk away with everything, and you'll get none.
Yeah, so that's Melissa Ramsky. She'll be our guest for our interview next Wednesday night right here, sitting on the tailgate. I'm your host, Big Country, and I'm getting out of here. It's time to go take some more drugs and see if I can't kick this damn cold. I'm telling you. But anyways, check us out, www.wbcwradio.com. That'll give you a link to everything we got going on. Don't forget to check out our shows this Friday and Saturday. If you got any comments, you can hit us up on wbcwradio.com. Go to the contact page and leave us a message. You know, just tell us how we're doing, if we're not doing, or if you got a request of something for one of our shows, you know, or if you just want to say, kiss my butt, you know, whatever. But hey, it's all about the fans and the artists, you know. Me, I can care less. So, until next time, I will see you guys later. I'm out of here. I'm riding on the horse.